Hello everyone. In number 5 challenging problem series, we're going to be solving a quintic equation with a parameter. A is a given number, solve for x. So we do have a fifth degree equation on the left hand side and a to the fifth plus 1 over a to the fifth on the right hand side. So what we're going to do is we're going to use change of variables here. So I'm going to go ahead and define y plus 1 over y as x. And then I'm just going to go ahead and square both sides of this, and I'll be getting y squared plus 1 over y squared is equal to, if you square this expression, you'll also get 2 in the middle. So I'm going to go ahead and subtract that, and I'll get x squared minus 2. Now, I'll try to get y cubed plus 1 over y cubed from here, but not by cubing. I'm going to go ahead and take this y squared plus 1 over y squared, multiply that by y plus 1 over y, and when I do, I will be getting what I want plus y plus 1 over y extra. So I'm going to go ahead and subtract that. And when I do, I'll be getting the answer. Y squared plus 1 over y squared, we calculated here, it should be x squared minus 2 multiplied by x minus x again. And if you go ahead and distribute and simplify this, you should be getting x cubed minus 3x. Okay, so this is the sum of the two cubes. Let's go ahead and calculate y to the fourth plus 1 over y to the fourth. Similarly, we're going to take the cubes and multiply that by y plus 1 over y. And the terms that we don't want are going to be y squared plus 1 over y squared. So we're going to go ahead and subtract that. And from here, we're going to be getting y cubed plus 1 over y cubed is equal to x cubed minus 3x. As you know, this is the very first thing that we defined, which is x minus. And if you remember, the sum of squares was x squared minus 2. Okay? Let's go ahead and simplify this expression to find the sum of fourth powers. This will be x to the fourth minus 3x squared minus x squared, which is minus 4x squared plus 2. Okay. Now, similarly, we're going to go ahead and calculate y to the fifth plus 1 over y to the fifth. Okay? And to get that, we're going to use y to the fourth plus 1 over y to the fourth, multiply by y plus 1 over y, minus, we're going to need to subtract y cubed plus 1 over y cubed. Okay, y to the fourth plus 1 over y to the fourth is going to be x to the fourth minus 4x squared plus 2, multiplied by x, minus, the cubes was this one, right? X cubed minus 3x, so we're going to go ahead and subtract that, x cubed minus 3x, okay? And if you go ahead and distribute this, you're going to be getting x to the fifth minus 4x cubed minus x cubed. That's going to give you minus 5x cubed. And then we're going to get 2x plus 3x, which is 5x. Okay. So basically, what we found at the end of this is the expression on the left-hand side. And this is y to the fifth plus 1 over y to the fifth, right? So that means y to the fifth plus 1 over y to the fifth is the same as a to the fifth plus 1 over a to the fifth. So a is a given number here. So a is a parameter. You have to consider that a is not a variable. But of course, for different values of a, we're going to find a bunch of different solutions. Okay, so we're going to be looking at cases here. Case by case, we're going to investigate it. First of all, if a is negative 1, then we're going to be getting y to the fifth plus 1 over y to the fifth is equal to negative 2, right? This is going to equal negative 2. And from here, we're going to get y equals negative 1, meaning that x equals y plus 1 over y, which is equal to negative 2. Okay, so if a equals negative 1, x equals negative 2. Okay? The second case is if a equals 0. Obviously, if a equals 0, there are no solutions, right? And another case that we're going to be looking at would be a equals 1. Those are special cases. If a equals 1, what happens? Then y to the fifth plus 1 over y to the fifth is going to equal 2. And from here, we're going to get y equals 1. You can kind of solve this as a quadratic equation, changing variables. And then you'll notice that it's going to be 1 from here, the only solution. Okay? And if y equals 1, then x is going to be 2. Okay? And then we're going to be looking at another case here. If a is not equal to any of these numbers, so if a does not equal plus minus 1 or a does not equal 0, then we're just going to be getting y equals a directly, right? And this will imply that x equals a plus 1 over a. Now, there's another solution here, which is y could also be 1 over a, but that will give you the exact same solution. So we don't really need to worry about that. Okay? So these are all the solutions based upon the values of a, and we covered basically everything, all the special cases, and these are all the solutions of the quintic parametric equation. Thanks for watching. Feel free to comment, and don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video. Have a good one. Bye-bye.